We are speaking today about the lockdown and the issue that we have to face the new normal that everybody affirms now. So no matter that we get rid of this virus as it's natural, it's a coronavirus. Even if it's modified, it's one of the hundreds of coronaviruses that make the common flu, the common cold. So even the Icelanders, the researchers discovered that there's more than 30, 40 strains of this virus. So who is this bloody virus that we are all fighting? I'm very curious and I'm very curious what kind of vaccine they will prepare for us because a vaccine cannot deal with more than two. I mean, Paddy spoke enough about vaccines and what it is in the vaccines and the fact that for decades people have been vaccinated without knowing what the hell is in their blood and, you know, why there's so much sickness in places in which people do not receive much medication. I can tell you, because I'm a Romanian, that in my country, only in Bucharest, where I lived all my life before coming here, there are 1,000 companies, 1,000 pharmacies, and even one of them has got 50,000 products, and has got supermarkets as big as a mall almost. That's the kind of medical services you can get in a country that was economically destroyed after the dictator. That was the plan of the International Monetary Fund for Romania. And still, we have all this medication, and we have more medical services than here. You know, I was stunned to see, you know, the degree of sicknesses in this population of yours. I thought it's unreal, and obesity, and the you know, the poor medical services we've got here. I want to tell you that even the communities of gypsies of my country who come to this this place know that if they have health issues, they should go back to Romania. Yeah. They have absolutely no medical knowledge, but they know that. They're not going to be cured by paracetamol, by a printed paper. Right. There is a catastrophic situation that you are confronted with here in matters of health. And there are many, many other issues. And I want to know, if the government cares so much about the health of these people, why don't they speak about all of them? Why don't they speak about glyphosate that you get in your food through bread and cereals non-stop? And glyphosate in Roundup, which is a herbicide made by Monsanto, is a substance that has given, that's documented, has given cancer to people in America, and they got millions as reward for that.
Because they put it on the children's cereals.
So, yeah, it's everywhere. And if you look even at the grass, if you see all around, if you see dry or yellow grass, this is not natural, because they want to kill the weeds in the park where you and your children are going. That's what they are doing. It's one of the most toxic substances that you can get. So everybody feeds on glyphosate today. What else? Somebody mentioned the trails on the sky, and we all know we have to believe that contrails, that's natural things that comes out of the plane. Since 2002, I discovered that we have these trails up on the sky, and they don't go away. They don't vanish. They turn into
a blanket.
Certain weird type of clouds.
Yeah, they were blocking the sun. Blocking the sun.
They call it geoengineering.
There is a software where through which you can. I think it's iFlight or something 24. You can check out the planes that go, you know, all over the earth, the commercial planes, and you will easily understand that these things that leave these long-lasting trails are not commercial planes.
No.
Are something else. They're not registered.
Yeah, we've seen them on YouTube.
You see them starting, you know, pulverizing the stuff and stopping. This is not natural. You cannot start and stop, you know, whenever you want, if it's, you know, the right thing. So we have this. It is a great amount of research about this in the world. In the European Parliament, scientists have spoken about this. It is again aluminium, barium, and strontium, nanoparticles, even red blood cells that are pulverized in the air. And these are in a nanoparticle form. So they can get through anything. You cannot stop them. And we are facing this at any time. You know, the lockdowns didn't stop these guys from doing their job. They will never, you know, remain without jobs, so it seems. So I said about glyphosate, about, you know, aerosol spray. And what else was it, right? I don't know. We know about vaccines and what they do with them. And if you speak about the new vaccines, we for sure will never know what they put in them. But what I know, for example, is that last year in Italy, there was a team of experts, they're called Corferva, and they've investigated four of the most common vaccines given to children and discovered retroviruses in them and discovered a great amount of nanoparticles, nano-sized particles that were completely unidentified, but they were non-biocompatible and non-biodegradable. This means that your body cannot get rid of them and that they are not supposed to be in your body, and they don't know what will happen to you if you are, you know, if you're having this in your body. So anyway, the idea is that we have to face all this, but I can tell you one thing. It all depends on our solidarity, and all depends on, you know,
solidarity.
Back into the history, wherever people have managed to impose a dictature, it was not because they had evil leaders. Evil people are everywhere. It says that maybe 5% of the male population, for example, is composed of psychopaths. So it's something that comes in a way or the other natural. But the idea is,
this is Glasgow, you're in. It's a bit higher.
They are opposed by an awakened people or not. It depends on the percentage all the time. If you are
in the water
in a care home, as I do, if you are working in a care home and you see there are things happening that are not supposed to happen, and you keep silence, no matter the price, there's no human value in that, there's no solidarity. And this is the mechanism through which every dictator manages to rule people. This is called compliance. This is called, you know,
acquiescence.
Silence is the biggest form of consent.
Silence is the biggest form of consent. It's more than silence.
Silence no more.
You trade your soul.
Yeah.
You trade your soul.
Yeah. Ella Wilcox said, to sin by silence is to make cowards out of men. Great phrase.
Brilliant. I would say even more, you can make killers out of men. Psychology proves that.
All it takes for evil to prevail is for good men to remain silent.
Yeah, I would say even that these are not good men. Good men cannot be silent in front of evil.
Yeah. Yeah, well said.
Thank you so much. Speaking about Christians, I am a Christian, and I am in total dismay because I see them, you know, like living in another world, in a bubble, you know. I don't see anybody standing up, almost anybody standing up for any of these critical issues that we are facing in. I mean, you can drop an atomic bomb and Christian would obey authorities, you know. And I want to tell you, maybe you don't know, that in the Old Testament, Ezekiel speaks about the watchman. The watchman is the man of God who looks for the community. And whatever happens evil in the community, he needs to shout the trumpet. He needs to speak out or else the blood will be on his hands. Yes. Where are the watchmen of Christianity today? There's nothing more that can, you know, help us, that can make us win this fight, than love, than true charity, true solidarity. We have to come. We are together in this. God is with us, and if God is with us, who can be against us?
No one. No one can. No one can lose. No chance. No chance. Thank you. Thank you.